This is our Disney News Hour, and many thanks for watching us with the news. I'm Shifar Alako, and do stay with us. Now, CNN's recent report about the floating dead bodies seen on the Tekaze River appears to be unsubstantiated and one-sided, deliberately produced by a Sudanese descent journalist to put undue pressure on the Ethiopian government. The Ethiopian government has been seriously warning the whole world that the TPLF was transporting the dead bodies of its fighters to bury them in mass and throw them into rivers to blame it on the federal troops. CNN's recent report proves how the story was developed and produced in close collaboration with the TPLF to execute its previous plan of using the dead bodies of its fighters for propaganda consumption. The man featured in the report is a member of the TPLF who was not even conscious enough to remove his hat, which praises the TPLF and its birthday. The text at the front of his hat marks February 18, which is the founding date of the TPLF. The text at the back of his hat also praises the TPLF. CNN deliberately produced a story based on a fairy tale, ignoring real massacres committed by the TPLF in the state of Afar and Amhara. I beg your pardon, the TPLF massacred more than 1,000 ethnic Amharas in Maikadra and killed more than 200 civilians, most of them women and children sheltered in a refugee camp in the state of Afar. CNN has no appetite to report a single story on these real facts. Instead, it is digging for fabricated and unsubstantiated stories elsewhere. The prominent reggae singer Zeleka Gassassa calls upon Ethiopians to fortify national unity. Talking to ETV English, Zeleka said he is doing his level best to use the power of music to nurture social harmony. Alola Teklamare reports.
Sun is always shining, the weather is so sweet. That's such a better puna and beautiful people to me. On the street, everywhere.
Documents show that Ethiopia remains at the heart of many reggae enthusiasts around the world, as it features in several songs by legendary Jamaican artist Bob Marley, the genre's biggest star. Many Ethiopian artists joined the reggae music style, of which Zeleka Gassassa is an artist whose contribution to Ethiopian reggae is more than simply beautiful rhythms. The singer has been instrumental in two large showcases that celebrate reggae music in Ethiopia. Reggae music has a special acclaim in Zeleka's life.
It is different because it's the newest form of music, number one. Number two, it relates to everyday life of every human being in this planet. So that makes it different because it speaks reality.
In an exclusive interview with ETV, Zeleka said he is doing his level best to use the music art for a social harmony.
At this time too, we need their participation in trying to decrease the pressure of the Western governments on Ethiopia. Because as we are the symbol of freedom, yeah, we'll continue shining, yeah, and then we'll be the symbol of economic freedom. We're working on some collaboration idea for African unity, for to bring Africans together. Yeah. There is, in fact, for the Renaissance Dam, where I'm selected to be the PR and international relations department, yeah, for the new private sector committee.
Yeah.
On that one, we're thinking, well, you're taking the press conference
okay,
before we do it officially. But we're working with some African and Jamaican artists to do a collaboration in regards to the Renaissance Dam. Yeah, because it's an African dam. It's the largest African dam. Yeah. So it belongs to Africa.
Zeleka shares his New Year experience in different international stages while living in the US America and Jamaica.
Yes, New Year is interesting. It's not religious, so all Ethiopians celebrate it. In Chicago, where I lived for 30 years, I used to perform for the Ethiopian community. Not all every year, but once every 4 or 5 years, because I travel around the U.S. for New Year's. So Los Angeles, California, the Washington, D.C., Minnesota, everywhere we've been called. But my biggest one is Chicago Community Association, where I was one of the founders of that association. It's about 30 years old, and it's done a lot of things. So on those days, everybody comes out, because in the States, the professionals, like the professors, the doctors, and the bankers, they don't really come out to the restaurants and everything like we do, you know. But they come out for holiday with their family. So at the holidays, even they come from Michigan, the surrounding states, Michigan, Indiana, Minneapolis, and Missouri. So we get a big crowd for New Year's, September 11. And those are my experiences where I meet a lot of Ethiopians, because we don't meet there, you know. Life is so hectic. You run around, you know, living, school, work, and so the best part is of New Year for me is to meet all the Ethiopian expatriates. Here, the whole vibe, you know, the spirit of the population is amazing, you know. Everybody wants to have a hope, you know, from the poorest to the richest. And that you see that, you know. Over there, because it's our culture and it's uniquely timed, September 11, because it's not January like the Europeans or the Americans. Seasonal. So that's, because of that, it's different there, and it's limited to one day. Here we have Pagume too. We just started, you know, today. So it's a week-long celebration. And the spirit of the people, man, it's amazing, you know.
Meanwhile, Zeleka is optimistic on his country's socioeconomic development and expressed his plan to open a convention center that will help transform the music industry.
Well, we're planning to open a place pretty soon. It's a big one. It's the first in Africa. It will be a convention center, which have a meeting hall, a traditional place, a nightclub, a hotel, and the back of it is a music school. That's my legacy for Ethiopia. We only have one more process to get the land. It's a big place. First one in Africa. It integrated, yes. It's a big one. For me, the legacy is the music school, because very young people, the music business is low in Ethiopia because it didn't develop. A lot of artists have talent, but they don't know the business part. So we're going to lecture them. Once the business part and music. Oh no, music too. Yeah, I want to train new bands, and then call the international companies and showcase them. I did that in Chicago, so we'll take the Ethiopian music to the international market.
Moving on, Ethiopia and South Africa have signed an agreement to work together in the fields of science, technology, and innovation. The agreement is believed to be instrumental in exchanging experience between the two nations. Kasam Chani has more on that.
Ethiopia and South Africa inked an agreement to work together in the fields of science, technology and innovation. Solomon Belay, advisor at the Ministry of Innovation and Technology, dubs the agreement an important milestone for the two countries to strengthen their ties in tech.
በደቡብ አፍሪካና በኢትዮጵያ በኩል በሳይንስ ቴክኖሎጂ እና ኢኖቬሽን
The agreement will enable the two nations to carry out a wide range of mutually beneficial activities in tech, science and innovation. It will also allow them to share experiences in this field. Science and technology has its own big share in the 10-year economic development program of Ethiopia. So striking such deals will open doors for job creation, problem-solving innovations and effective use of resources.
South African Ambassador to Ethiopia Edward Makaya for his part said, science and technology play an important role in bilateral relations, economic growth and national development.
The two ministers of science and technology of South Africa and Ethiopia have just signed the Memorandum of Understanding on Scientific and Technological Cooperation. So this is an important occasion for the two countries. The objectives of the MOU is to promote information and technological cooperation between the two countries. Science and technology is a key in our bilateral relations, and it's an area that we want to pay a particular focus, because we can only succeed to grow our economies, to develop our own countries, if we put a bit of emphasis on science and technology and innovation.
The agreement was witnessed by Ethiopia's Minister of Innovation and Technology, Abraham Belay, and South Africa's Ambassador to Ethiopia, Edward Makaya.
Now in our continental news, Sunday, that's September 12, marked a week since the bloodless coup in Guinea that toppled President Alpha Conde. The international community has expressed concerns about these developments and demanded a return to civilian rule and unconditional rule of the ousted president. Gushu Melissa has more on that from CGTN.
The scenes of jubilation in Conakry following the overthrow of Alpha Conde show how much the Guinean people longed for a change in the way power was managed in this poor West African country. On Sunday, many Guineans continued to praise the action of the military in bringing an end to President Conde's regime. No clashes or demonstrations have been reported against the coup and its leaders so far. But what the Guineans themselves say about these turns of events in their country?
Depuis le coup d'état le 5 septembre 2021, la Guinée a eu l'indépendance de la Guinée. C'est ce que je veux dire. On a fini de faire la Guinée. Je veux dire, on a fini de faire la Guinée. Parce que je veux faire la Guinée. 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 Je veux faire la Guinée.
Moi, je soutiens le coup d'état militaire en Guinée. Parce que depuis 10 ans, on est en train de vivre avec une souffrance. On n'en parle même pas. On soutient les militaires, surtout moi avec beaucoup mes amis. On les soutient les militaires aussi. Moi, je pense bien, on attend que les militaires vont organiser l'élection, peut-être. Dans 6 mois ou bien une année aussi, ils vont organiser les élections libres et transparentes et vont libérer le pays. Bon, moi je veux dire à 100%, j'ai l'espoir, ça va changer. Le militaire là, le colonel Mamadi Doumbouya là, lui il va changer la Guinée de plus. J'ai l'espoir à 100%, lui il va changer la Guinée.
Ce coup d'état là,
Among the sectors most affected by the coup in Guinea are land and air transport. Road transporters are protesting the closure of Guinea's borders, with some neighboring countries blocking hundreds of trucks and light vehicles used to cross border traffic.
Andun kan wakali karbran kula amma fina transport ka ka be bruki brazil men france tra la brazil audi au moins ou dise que la casier du rattraper troani fin be yan kasila lam concentrer no beka be dit di bas allez to kulita me galu men al ka brati bela
on a numéro
donc l'air me re la voisité mom li kelen bi lo soma fura duli bagasi le talakawa.
A lawmaker in Somalia who became the country's first female foreign minister is now running for the presidency. Fozia Yusuf Adam is well aware of the challenges in winning votes in a conservative Muslim nation where women have been historically marginalized. Even friends and colleagues see her chances as next to nil because of her gender. But Adam, a widow and mother of three, said she believes her campaign for the presidency is worthwhile and could break down barriers for other women. She argues that her gender could be an asset in helping Somalia emerge from years of deadly violence marked by devastating attacks from the Al-Qaeda-linked Al-Shabaab extremist group. Like others across Somalia, she has watched as insecurity weakened the country's foundations. As Somalia moves toward a long-delayed presidential election, which has now been scheduled for October, she has her sights on the highest office of all. And finally, a quick reminder of the top stories. CNN report about the Tigray crisis appears to be unfounded and biased. And Ethiopia and South Africa ink agreement to cooperate in science and innovation. That's all the news there is for now. Many thanks for watching us, and bye-bye.